All of us are frustrated sometimes during the day. I'm not talking about that. That's a human characteristic. And it's there for a definite reason, to stimulate one to rise above it. And that's what success is. I'm talking about chronic frustration, some hurt feeling, some agony of distress, some heartache, some grief, some guilt of the past that we carry on our mental backs day in and day out, many, many years thereafter. So that's the frustration I'm talking about. And if we know these red light signs, we can avoid them. They have fear involved in it. We come into this world in uncertainty. We live in it, and we pass on in uncertainty. But the business of living is to rise above uncertainty, to bend it to our will. Frustration has an element of retreat. Just because you've made a mistake, you retreat from life. You can't do that. In that instance, you sort of surrender your self-image, your dignity. You can't do that either, because the only treasure house you have within you is your self-respect. And if you're going to deny it expression, no one else will help you. So that when you practice this chronic frustration, dramatically speaking, you're like a traitor to yourself. You take a knife and symbolically kill yourself, and you needn't do that. So that when you refuse to turn your back on negative feelings, you put yourself in the position there where you're like permitting termites within you to bore holes into your spiritual being, letting the fluids of your life force disappear down a drain. When people realize these dramatic aspects of it, that when you just hold on to negative feelings constantly, and that you're no more than a failure just because you failed, in these instances you practice chronic frustration and you become much less than what you're capable of being. It happens that Salvador Dali, a very dear friend of mine, this famous Spanish painter, gave me a painting of his concept of psycho-cybernetics. He had a world in it, and the one half of the world was in shadow from frustration, where man's image has shrunken to the size of a small potato. The other half is in sunlight from confidence. And there, man's image is 10 feet tall, and he's walking towards the sun. What is he trying to say? That's the whole essence of psycho-cybernetics. We're a composite, a combination of heartaches and happiness, of misfortunes and good luck. And we must realize that frustrations are there for us to rise above it and to turn it into a kinetic, productive force of confidence. Now, what is confidence? Is your capacity to rise above a mistake. So when you take the trick of the moneyed players in sports, now what happens with them? They're in a contest. They're out to win. Now, suppose they lose. They're not going to carry that loss into the next contest the next day. It reminds me of the time that when Babe Ruth struck out, one reporter said to him, "Babe, what do you think about when you strike out?" He said, "Well, I think of hitting home runs." Now, that's the point of living. You don't remember the thousands of times Babe Ruth struck out, but you remember that he was a SWAT king.
And if he had remembered the thousands of times he struck out every time,
he'd never hit the ball. Absolutely. So the point of the matter is, you think of the past, if you have to, of your confidences. The business of creative living, of psycho-cybernetics, which is the basis of our workshop that we're going to start this month, the 23rd and 25th of January at Marriott House, is just this, the essence of it. What are you going to be in life, a person of frustration or a person of confidence? And it's up to you to make a decision. When you look in the mirror, you're going to say, "What kind of day is this going to be for me, Charlie, old boy? What kind of day is it going to be for me, Betsy, baby?" You make the decision.